before we move to the cemetery itself, we will have a number of tributes, hespeidim, eulogies for Rabbi Sacks. First, I call upon my esteemed colleague, Rabbi Ginsbury, Senior Rabbi of Hendon Synagogue, to share his ideas and to read a message from the Chief Rabbi. Thank you, Rabbi Belovsky, Bechustein, Binstock, esteemed members of the family, friends who gather here. It's my privilege simply to read out the following message in memory of HaRav Lord Jonathan Sacks from the Chief Rabbi, Rabbi Ephraim Mirvis, who is unable to be here, as you'll understand, as I read his message. I am truly sorry that having been instructed by my NHS app to self-isolate, I'm not able to be here in person, and I'm grateful to Rabbi Mordechai Ginsbury for reading this Hesped. I feel inadequate delivering these words of tribute to my illustrious predecessor, Rabbi Lord Sacks, Zichrono Livracha. Mere words cannot do justice to Rabbi Sacks's extraordinary contribution to our world, nor to the monumental legacy he has left behind. To him we declare, Nasi Elokim Ata B'tochenu, you have been a prince of God in our midst. These words in Bereshit were originally addressed to Abraham, our patriarch, by the B'nai Chet, the Canaanite dwellers of the Holy Land. In a similar way, Rabbi Lord Sacks was a respected prince of God for the Jewish world and well beyond. He was a remarkable spiritual leader, educator, orator, author, philosopher, intellectual, broadcaster, and mentor. He was an outstanding ambassador for Judaism and our Torah, helping many to appreciate and be deeply proud of their heritage. It is difficult, if not impossible, for us to think of Rabbi Sacks in the past tense. He has been an integral part of our lives and an ongoing source of direction, motivation, and inspiration. In reality, though, he will never exist in the past. Such was his legacy, which will provide insight and inspiration for many years to come. A legacy which will highlight the relevance of our Torah tradition in modern times. A legacy that will enshrine the respectful place of religion within our ever-changing world. Amongst the numerous adjectives that describe his remarkable impact on countless individuals, for me the most significant is inspirational. I had the privilege of being his successor twice, first as rabbi of the Marble Arch community and then as chief rabbi. In occupying his pulpit of Marble Arch, I came to appreciate the deep inspirational impact he had on the community, which was then followed by his inspirational, national, and global impact. Rabbi Sacks's biblical namesake, Yaakov Avinu, is remembered for his voice. Yitzchak, his father, declared, "Hakol kol Yaakov." The voice is the voice of Jacob. Rabbi Sacks had a distinctive, powerful voice. He was the encouraging voice of hope and promise, the voice of faith, of morality, tolerance, moderation, humor, and love. Yaakov Avinu is introduced to us by the Torah as Yoshev Ohalim, a dweller of tents. Our sages provide two different ways to understand this term. According to the Medrash, Yaakov was a student of Shem and Eber, dwelling in tents to study as much as he could. In this regard, Rabbi Lord Sacks was a Yoshev Oalim of the highest pedigree, a world-renowned scholar and educator. Ibn Ezra, Rashbam, Chizkuni and others give a different perush. They explain that shepherds construct tents to protect themselves from the heat of the sun. As a Yoshev Oalim, Yaakov was a devoted shepherd. This too was the hallmark of Rabbi Lord Sacks. He was a Ro'e Ne'eman La'adato, a faithful shepherd to his flock, a rabbi of rabbis and leader of leaders who tended with love and devotion to respect to the needs of his people and our fragile world. Yaakov Avinu was also called Yisrael. In many places, Yaakov represents our patriarch as a family man, while Yisrael symbolizes his leadership of our people, and thus we are called B'nai Yisrael. In this spirit, Rabbi Lord Sacks often spoke to rabbis about our dual responsibility as family members and community leaders. He himself lived up admirably to this aspiration, and that's why right now our thoughts are so very much with his dear wife, Lady Elaine, their children, Joshua, Dina, and Gila, Rabbi Lord Sacks' brothers, Brian, Alan, and Elliot, and the entire family. May they be comforted by the knowledge that Rabbi Lord Sacks' remarkable legacy will live on in the hearts and minds of the countless people he inspired. Yehi zichro baruch. May the memory of this most remarkable man be for an eternal blessing. Amen.